again, and we will move in the second talk for tomorrow that is made from Daniele Scasciafratte that will talk about Firefox that could be your marionette. And Daniele is a part of the Mozilla Italia community and is a developer. So thank you and enjoy the talk.
Okay. So let's start with the topic that is quite clear, a marionette, and I think that everyone knows what is Firefox. I don't think I have to ask for this question in this room. And before to start to talk about the technology, I want to start talk a bit about me, just to understand the background, because I have a little bit of budget in room. I am part of the Mozilla community since 6 years now. I'm part of the Mozilla Health Program, inside the Labs Council, Mozilla Tech Speakers, like many others in this room. I've contributed to WordPress, also part of the classic press, this fork of WordPress right now, and president of the Italian Association About Professional. And I use Firefox for my job. But not only to surf the web, debug as many others, but also to automatize a little things that sometimes happen when you have to work with customers. So, I look at the internet. I don't know how many of you remember these on Reddit, forums, GitHub, whatever. This was a few years ago, was like amazing. Wow, these programmer developers that are doing scripts to not work. Now it's quite normal. Because, but you can find always on Quora, Reddit, whatever, that people is asking, it's a problem that if I automatize everything I do in my daily job, because people have problems sometimes with the boss. But for developers, it's common. When we do some things that is always the same, we want to script it. And I put this script of GitHub, because you can find, and I read it, this extract is about a chat that say, there's someone who was living inside the terminal. Oh, it's me. And you know, last week, okay, it's me again. And lockdown, blah, blah, blah. So, okay, probably I'm doing like the same script for me, like change the volume, I don't know. I have a recipe pedal to move the cursor between monitors. So I'm not the only one that is crazy and automatize things. And how is it possible today with browser? Because now with the web editing, it's quite important to know these kind of things. So I started thinking about, when I was doing these slides, about my personal rules for automation. If you do a mono process for more than 3 times, that is always the same, always. So, click there, download something, write to someone, whatever, on the computer, of course. You can do it at some mobile, this is possible, Android, very quick, easy, and I do also there, but on computer. But then you can replicate with scripting. So this is the point. Understand what I can replicate. Because usually when something doesn't have API, whatever, it's kind of difficult. And that you want to relax more. Because maybe it's something critical, I don't know, backup, production, you know, this kind of things, testing. So you want to be sure that everything was fine. Because as developer, we want to sleep pretty well every night. Because, you know, it's a problem. And often that is boring, because for developers always do the same thing is boring. After all, we have computers, a machine, they are perfect to do always the same things. They are made for it, so why not use them for boring stuff? And of course, that a missing step can create issues. Again, a backup, I forgot a step, the backup is broken, it's a problem. So, automation helps us on these kind of things, because we are sure that everything is always the same. Time to the script, of course. So this is my workflow. When I, for my job, I have to do a script. And during the time I saw right now, I was looking, in the last years I made a lot of script. But for editing. Of course, I mean on GitHub, whatever, publish it because I like it, because usually when you want to do something, someone else made the same thing. So you have only to change a little bit for your needs. So it's time to do scripting. I don't know how here how many wants to do scripting like Bash, Python, Node.js, I don't know. Show your hands. Okay, everyone, okay. So it is. we are not looking for button, but for the terminal. Okay, so starting talking about bosons and scripting. There are three ways for doing that. The first one is web extensions. Web extensions, for who doesn't know, will be at your talk tomorrow in another room, the JavaScript one, and web extensions are the add-ons for the browsers. Firefox is famous because was the first one with extension, and it is the biggest marketplace for extensions. So you can find for everything you need, but has some limitations. But it's very easy to do one. We have scripting with CLI, of course, because every browser has commands. The last one is unit test system and the tools protocol that offers the Firefox as an example, but just because we are in this room, we are taking Firefox as an example. So, what is of these three options the most powerful and most fun? The third one. And now we will see why. Okay, starting with web extensions, there will be also my talks of the last years about it on FOSDEM. And the first one is cross-browser compatibility. Now with this API, you can do it. The same extension and works in Firefox, Chrome, Opera, I don't remember now the status, etc. So the biggest ones works. Cool, compatibility everywhere. We like it. The API is stable between various releases. This was the biggest point because if I develop, I have to test every time Firefox release a new version, can be a big problem. When you have 10 extensions, it's a very big problem. But with the web extension now, we don't have problems. Like me, I have 10 extensions, works since years now with Firefox. I don't have to care about Firefox that is changing or Chrome because it's stable. So it's good for developers. The interesting fact, but again, because we are in this room, Firefox has more APIs for web extensions compared to Chrome, because Firefox was from the start very expandable for us. And there is a huge marketplace of users. If you want to release your extension, you can reach like any Firefox users quite easy. So if you want to do an extension for this kind of reason, this is the perfect solution. The problem is that it is a full for specific kind of task. So, in shell scripting we have the missing clause of the browser compatibility because commands are different. We have only specific features available, like SwitchOut for that reason, like in Firefox. It's only for very highly skilled users, the ones that use the terminal as an example. And again, it's useful only for specific kind of tasks because the commands are not so many. Instead, unit test system and their tools protocol are very, very powerful because we have today now two features for Chrome that is most used right now, that is Node.js. We have Selenium that is most famous. The problem can be that is Java, but we did this for other languages, so it's not so much, so that should be a problem. The problem is that Firefox is supported to the 55 version, now we have the 65. Because it's supporting the old web drivers version of Firefox Switcher 21. So right now, Selenium is not working with Firefox since 2 years. So Selenium released an extension for Firefox and Chrome, that is Selenium ID, that fixed this problem. We have also a feature for Firefox in Node.js, but it's experimental. So experimental is not so good for us. But there is Marionette for Firefox, and also Firefox for Android, that is in Python. So, I think that you everyone knows Pinocchio. Pinocchio is the most famous marionette in the world. But the problem is that this one is the original marionette in Italy. If you go in Italy, Pinocchio is this. It's not a Disney version. So, I chose to say that because no one knows that, but Pinocchio is quite famous in Italy, and this is the right one. So, what is the marionette in the deep world? The Marionette framework for Firefox. Marionette is a remote protocol, this is the definition from the documentation of Mozilla, that lets you to communicate with Firefox quite easily in all the GIGO-based browsers like Firefox for Android. At the time also with Firefox OS as an example. And this works because Mozilla uses it for the unit test, so we are using something that is used in a little project, we can say. So, the question now is, how to use it for something that is not for unit testing? enable Marionette in your Firefox, the first step. The problem is that you need a specific build of Firefox because it's only included only on the developer edition as an example, or in Ivory because it's used for development, so in this table doesn't make a lot of sense to have Marionette. The next step is to install the drive, the framework that is for Python 2 right now, not 3, it's not yet supported. And verify to have the latest version. This is very important in the past because now with the latest releases of Firefox they stabilize everything. So years ago was a problem when you have not the last version of Marionette but the last version of Firefox wasn't working. Now the last release of May of the last year, so it's quite stable. So it's not a problem anymore, but a check is always good. The second step is to enable it. You can enable in the settings and set the port because we will open a socket connection. Or you can choose to execute Firefox in the Marionette mode. This is all you can do on Firefox in that way. So how it works? It's a bridge between your script and Firefox itself. And it's different to use the DevTools protocol because Puppeteer uses the DevTools protocol, but it's not powerful like a unit test system because you can control not only the web view but also the interface of Firefox. So it can be powerful for specific kind of things more than usual. And it's based on the web driver specific standard from V3C, so this framework is a web wrapper of this technology, so we don't need to speak web driver but we use Python for it. So my story is that as a volunteer I use Firefox as I said and I try also to do evangelism like I think many others in this room to use Mozilla technologies. So I don't know how many here promote Mozilla technologies at their job. I don't know. How many of you? Okay, we need to go about this point. So I chose to use Firefox also for this because I don't want to use Chrome for do automatize this kind of things. I say, how can I do it in Firefox? And I started using for my job, but also to help other open source communities. And my usual workflow when I have to do this kind of tools is that I need to pass something in real time, or I can do a pass later. Because usually when I saw my experience, there are two ways of to a script. I want to download everything and later pass it because maybe something critical in production, I don't want to change anything, I can work later because there is a huge amount of data. So, depends on the starting point, what I have to do. Analyze the flow of the process of how many stuff I have to click, change, and determine, I mean, the different parameters. Usually I do a config file that is more easy, also for other people. Or I can open the manually the URL because it's more easy. Depends on what I need and how much priority I need to do for my customers. And evaluate if I need the headless mode because Firefox supported now. If also other will use this tool, so I cannot do it create spaghetti code as an example. So we need to be clean. And that's why I think that I make always how to configure Firefox because every time I forget. So that's all the people doesn't know, so better that every time. So let's start with the most famous project I did. This one is for the WordPress community to manage the localization of strings. Because in the WordPress community we have a tool that is called the consistency tool that shows you how many versions there is of this translation of this term in a specific language. So in the current community we have a problem of as I don't know button localized in 14 ways different. So it's a problem for consistency. And I cannot manage 52,000 plugins and review all of them manually. So I made a script that based on a config file I can reject all the wrong localization. And now people is contributing and adding up some new features like replace with a new localization, etc. Because this tool in WordPress doesn't have a REST API or whatever. So I was needing something that I can run while I was working, but fixing the localization for all the WordPress users, in my case with the Italian language. And it's used a lot, this tool. The second one I did for job is an exporter for WordPress post when you don't have permissions for do it. There is the story, I can do quickly because of time. If you want to get customers with more over than 400 posts that they have to export but doesn't have database access, FTP access, admin permissions, API blocked, everything. So the only way was using the backend of WordPress and they have a demo of it. with a video. We see Firefox is enabled in Marionette mode because the URL is changed. I have the script there running. This is the post, this is my website. You see opened automatically a new tab, waiting that is loaded, and move on the next one. When the list is finished, you will use the pagination move on the second page or whatever. For every tab that I open in the other page, I download the HTML two parts later, because I have two parts. 400 posts, for that different reason, this hosting was very good, so I don't want to do the parts in real time, I prefer to do it later. But at the meantime, before that, the other company that was doing the previous website closed the website, I had the data. So this is a simple way that the user to export a lot of posts from there, parsed, and prepare it for a new file to import to WordPress without errors access. So how works? Code. We love code. We have the connection. We import the library. We start the session with Firefox. We use selectors, CSS selectors. We pick all the title in the page. We do a loop. For new one, we open a new tab. Middle clicking Firefox and that's in Chrome is a way to open the link in a new tab. In a way, I don't change the page. I open the page in another tab, write the HTML of that page, because I can parse later with other library. In Python, is good for scraping, and switch back to the previous window with less one. In that way, I did a very easy script that loop, and download all the pages as a logged users without use any other kind of tools and work it. I say to the customer that I did 40 hours instead of 2. So this is a way to automatize how can help you. And another feature I have to do when I come back of this conference is I need to export from Google Analytics 170,000 URLs. A lot. I can say very a lot from Google Analytics. The problem is that the web interface supports only 5,000 per page to export. So you can understand it's very, very difficult to do manually. And the API of Google requires a license, and we don't want to pay Google. So our idea was to do a script like this, pagination, download, and with Firefox to auto-pick the download button. It automatically switch the next page so I can download again another URL. And with the script that we have, we compare this list with another one because later we have to remove only a little bit of this URL from the website. So this is an idea of a problem or to resolve and something that I can really use maybe with the next customer or the same customers. Quite easy because after all, the script will work in the time. Python works, the framework is stable, whatever, so it will work. So, conclusion, resources, we have two blog posts written by Anjana, these are all the Mozilla Tech speakers that explain in the details everything, how works, the results of the documentation, because there is the documentation. And it's very, very good, the documentation. Just to be sure, it's very good, the documentation. And that's it. So, I'm here for all of your questions.
Are there any plans to support Python 3?
Yes, in Mozilla they're planning. The problem is that Mozilla uses a lot of Python in a lot of tools, and many of the dependencies of Marionette doesn't support Python 3. So the problem is on this side, and as you saw about the ticket before to go there, they are very late on porting. So I think that before Python shut down the two guys, so probably we have the support for Python 3, but in one time still works, so these are good.
Exist wrapper in other languages?
No.
Node.js?
There is? Okay, in Perl. Okay, this is in Perl. Okay, but not in the JS. There is the perpetual for Firefox using the DevTools protocol, but it's experimental. So soon there will be, but using the DevTools.
Okay. Other questions?
There is one.
Okay.
Okay.
Hi, thank you for the talk. I've seen you were using a middle click to actually open a new tab in your previous automation script. Is it also possible to be more low level, like opening new tab?
Yeah, you can do it, because we have all the actions that you can do it in Firefox. I chose a middle click because it was the most easy way to achieve what I need. But we have all the actions that you want with the mouse, cable, whatever. So you can do whatever you want, basically.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
I'm Henrik, I work on Marionette and the implementation at Mozilla. Just a comment on the new tab thing, that's something we implemented for Firefox 66. So we have a new command now you can run to simply open a new window or a new tab. Because middle click doesn't always work and other techniques doesn't work always. Something I want to mention is, you mentioned that it's Selenium stop support for Firefox 55. That's only true for the Firefox extension, which was working with the
new one,
right? Because we switched to Quantum and 57, didn't allow those old extensions anymore. But since then, we have Gecko Driver, which is a replacement, and it's fully working with up to Firefox 66, and with Selenium, the latest version.
Yeah, I saw Gecko Driver, but I'm still using Marionette, so that was quite news. I forgot to talk about something that is stable.
And I just want to mention that something you didn't know maybe yet. We want to discontinue the Marionette client Python package because we want to have all working via web driver. So that means for you, in your cases, you might have a change.
We will do it.
Okay, and if you have more questions about Marionette, you can also come to me later, I think.
Any other question? No? Okay, so thank you so much, Daniele.